circles. There are two circles, circle of victory and vicious circle. If you just enter into the domain of the positive thinking people, positive vibration people, it is the circle, the domain of victory. If you enter into the domain of the negative thinkers, where the negative vibration, the ignorance and the darkness, the disappointment and the disillusion is there, it is the vicious circle. Poison, venom will be the result. Death, damage will be the result. Disaster, decay will be the result. So, in yoga, everybody bubbling. Everybody in yoga bubbling. Everybody is flexible. Everybody is mobile here. Everybody is positive. Overall, when you do a meditation particularly, there is a positive vibration all around. Alone when you do meditation, there will be glow. But when a lot of people are there, particularly powerful, when the powerful people are there, people with extraordinary inner strength, if they are there, the glow, the aura that is coming out of them will be so powerful, you enter into the region of positive vibrations, positive cycle, positive circle, which re-energizes, recharges. The coming to the yoga class itself is like getting the recharge. The battery is recharged here. All the people will be having the positive energy, positive currents of flowing. The thought waves are the thought currents which will be hitting your mind. Every second, thought waves will be hitting, thought currents are hitting. Even when you are looking at me and see me still, the thought waves and thought currents are operating from within. And if you allow the dark shadow, negative thought waves to overtake you, then you are suppressed. Result, you get depressed, you enter into depression. If you are in the group of the people who are bubbling, energetic and positive vibrations, automatically whatever dust that is there, whatever dirt that is there, whatever darkness that is there will be taken out. Everything becomes clear, clean, pure, neat, white, bright, beautiful, brilliant. Remarkable. So this is what is called a psychosomatic impact and influence of yoga on the mind and the body, the intellect and the spirit of the people who practice the yoga. And I have seen another important difference between the people who practice yoga and not practicing yoga. People who practice yoga, generally you know the people, you talk to the people, a lot of people are there, and you have to, and you smile, the frequency of smile increases here. And you have to smile, and it gives enhanced face value. Smile increases the face value. And smile makes you cheerful. And another important benefit that I have observed over the years by practicing yoga is the people who practice yoga, their foresight, their vision, their dream, their imaginative, innovative potentials will be extraordinary and greater. The vision, all your future achievement depends upon your ability to dream, thinking big, thinking great, visualizing great. That vision, imagination, dreaming, that is enhanced because the mind power, vital mind power, strength of the mind, positive vibrations, practical vibrations, achievement of the practical things. Mind always thinks of the practical things, achieving that. So that is what is called as the enhancing of mental strength for diversifying and making it a possible dream, possible vision, which I call as foresight. All the greatest achievements of the world and greatest constructions of the world have been manufactured twice. Every greatest thing in the world has been manufactured twice. First, in the mind of some person. Secondly, translated into actuality or reality. This first appearing in the mind of the person is what is called as planning, programming, scheduling, dreaming, visualizing, conceptualizing, which is the cutting edge for the success of any person. And the yoga indirectly enhances foresight, sighting, foresight, vision and visionaries. Yogic people become visionaries. In fact, when there was no university concept, when there was no computer, when there was no web system, when there was no printing technology, when there is no journals and magazines, Rishis in India, 5000 years ago, 10,000 years ago, we just go through the scriptures, they had so much of wisdom, so much of knowledge, so much of analysis, so much of synthesis, so much of perfect and extraordinary understanding of the internal world and the external world, where from they got it. There was no tutoring, there was no library, there was no computer, there was no website, and there was no university, and there was no interaction at all. Only one person in the corner of the forest, in the remote place, just closing the eyes and sitting, where from he got it. It is the potential within what I call as vision, visionary, visualizing, inciting, insight, intuition, foresight, vision, dreams. It is that today the Microsoft company is there, or Infosys company is there, that virtually came in the mind of some person, then developed into an organization. That is the personality that you are going to get. As a benefit of the yoga, spiritual personality is the best personality, the best part of the development and the benefit of the yoga. You become spiritual, you can stand into this world, you can withstand any vagaries, you can withstand any type of disappointment. If there is a volcano, you are not affected. If there is an earthquake, you are not affected. If there is a problem, you are not affected. If there is a recession, you are not affected. In a country like America, which is a superpower, which is almost like the biggest brother of all the countries in the world, suddenly there is a recession, when there is a financial depression, you know what happened to the mental state of many, many people there. You know about it. And yoga, indirectly, always Rajendra insists one thing, yoga is not just a physical asana practice, its foundation is in the strong philosophy of life. Yoga is a philosophy, based on philosophy, founded on philosophy. So we have to understand the philosophy. And those people who practice the Vasudeva Kriya Yoga, he sees that. In fact, next year his best book will be released. He's writing a beautiful book, Philosophy of Yoga, A to Z of Yoga. He's writing, it will be released next year. There he is pioneering, championing the cause. Yoga should be firmly based on the foundations of strong philosophy. Durable philosophy, tested philosophy, trusted philosophy, time-tested philosophy, then only it can be called yoga. And indirectly, gradually, over a period of time of understanding all the concepts which is telling, you get into the philosophical world, you get into the spiritual world, you become spiritual, and spirituality gives you tranquility, serenity, peace of mind, proper understanding, balance, equanimity, withstanding ability to any acid test, any tension situation. This is the effective personality benefit that is available from the yoga. The foresight and the vision is the yoga. Then yogic people, they become gentle. They become gentle. The manners, mannerisms, behaviors, interactions of the people who practice yoga will be different from others. Here, the gentle manners, the gentleness, the culture, the decency, the dignity, interrelationship is indirectly taught over. Most important benefit that I derive and I see in most of the people is direct benefit. Greatest benefit is health benefits. Health benefits. But I have seen many, many cases where BP automatically has become normal. The digestion system becoming totally normal. Earlier, the fellows who were inflammable, explosive, highly emotional, hyper fellows becoming cool, normal, calm. Total balance control is available. And emotion charging is now becoming reason, rational, normal.